Welcome to 1050X, Analysis of Transport Phenomena. My name is Martin Bezant, Professor of Chemical Engineering and Mathematics at MIT, and I'll be your guide through an experiment in digital learning to teach graduate-level engineering with advanced mathematics in a massive open online course. In this course, you'll learn how to formulate continuum models of heat and mass transfer based on partial differential equations, and solve them the old-fashioned way, analytically, using only pencil and paper. Since many problems are too difficult to solve exactly, you will also learn the art of approximation, how to simplify a model enough to obtain an analytical solution while still capturing the key physics. Even in the age of computers, such solutions play a crucial role in the design of engineering systems and our understanding of their operating principles. For example, consider the design of lithium metal batteries, which could enhance the driving range and power of electric vehicles, if only they could be designed for safe recharging and long cycle life. In this course, we will learn how to analyze interfacial mass conservation and transient diffusion to predict when slow, stable lithium growth suddenly transitions to the rapid growth of a dangerous dendrite at the onset of diffusion limitation. You will learn the principles of fluid dynamics by directly solving the equations of motion. For example, we will study how narrowly confined flows are able to lubricate metal gears and engines, apply liquid coatings to solid substrates, and carry blood through capillaries. You will also learn the principles of hydrodynamic instability, how tiny perturbations in fluid flow can spontaneously grow into complex and often beautiful patterns that control heat and mass transfer. Imagine forcing a fluid, such as air or water, into a thin gap or porous medium filled with a more viscous fluid, such as oil or a molten polymer. In order to find the path of least resistance, the interface between the fluids becomes unstable as fingers of the less viscous fluid penetrate the more viscous one. This phenomenon of viscous fingering is undesirable in some situations, such as oil recovery, but convenient in others, such as drug delivery or membrane design. Next, we will apply our models of fluid flow to convective heat and mass transfer. For example, we will analyze the process of sparging, which involves mass transfer from rising bubbles, such as oxygen in bioreactors or nitrogen in beer or coffee. We will also study natural convection driven by buoyancy forces, as in the boiling of water heated from below, as well as other examples of phase transformations such as solidification, melting, and drying. You will then learn the principles of non-equilibrium thermodynamics, which govern phase separation in lithium-ion battery electrodes, as well as the formation of liquid organelles in biological cells. Finally, we will study electrochemical transport of ions, as in water desalination by electrodialysis, or signal propagation in the nervous system. In this course, we will survey a variety of mathematical methods and applications through Lightboard lecture videos, which are augmented by online tutorials that promote active learning. At MIT, 1050 is a challenging rite of passage for all first-year PhD students in chemical engineering, and it also attracts students from other science and engineering departments. If you have some familiarity with multivariable calculus and ordinary differential equations, we encourage you to give this course a try. Previous exposure to the principles of heat and mass transfer and fluid mechanics is helpful, but not required. If you're ready to work hard, we'll teach you everything you need to know to begin analyzing transport phenomena.